We've made it to week number 10, and the Browns, yes, the Browns are 7-1 on the season. With the Rams being 5-3, we got a pretty tough opponent this week, but I got good news. We're at home, and we still have Isaiah King. And speaking of Isaiah King, who's a 96 overall, now it's time to give him not one, but two upgrades this week. So you know what? Power Max should be the move because he's now a 94 overall and elusive, and that's kind of sitting in a pretty good area. So now he's an 86 overall through Power Back perspective. He gets plus one of ball carrier vision and stiff arm and plus two to trucking. But no. We're not done yet. We're going to go again to the power back spot, increase that a little bit more. See if we can get, he's an 87 overall from there now, plus one to awareness of stiff arm and plus two to trucking yet again. Now, the best possible news we could ever get is that EJ Manuel is no longer our quarterback, because what do you see here? Well, you don't see Baker Mayfield's name. And as you can see here, Baker is finally healthy. He's an 82 overall, and I could not be happier to get this guy back in the field because our passing game will finally be worth something again. And if we look back to week number 9, a week that we ultimately simmed, Isaiah had 14 carries, 167 yards, 2 rushing touchdowns, 5 catches, 58 yards, and a receiving touchdown. That's kind of crazy, but you know what? I was making fun of EJ Manuel. But in week number 8 that we simmed as well, he was 24-29, almost 300 passing yards, 3 passing touchdowns, got sacked twice, it is what it is, and ran for 3 yards, but EJ Manuel in 20, whatever we are in now, one offensive player of the week. Imagine that. It feels good to be in Cleveland, and even though we got fireworks going off, as you can tell, it's raining in Ohio right now. So we're gonna see what we can do here. We're rocking the orange uniforms today. The Rams got the pretty much all-white uniforms, and I'm hyped. Our defense has been playing pretty well. We have Baker Mayfield back for his return game today. Look at the young fella coming out the tunnel. You can tell he's hyped. You know Isaiah's gonna be hyped. The dude has been putting up numbers all season. He is on pace right now to break the NFL single-season rushing record. He's telling Jarvis Landry, look, tonight, it's going to be historic because last week was not too bad. Now, we ended up winning this all, so we get the ball first. So we have the ball right here from the 25. We could let Baker pass it on his first attempt back, but nah, we'd rather let Isaiah run over somebody. I'm honestly fully sold on Baker Mayfield just dominating because, look, if Isaiah's running the ball like that, defenses have to, just respect it. And that was a dot. It just wasn't held on to by Josh Gordon. Now, another big thing, if Isaiah gets one rushing touchdown today, it is his 30th rushing touchdown of his career. That's already a big number for a dude that hasn't been in the NFL that long, but look at that, scattered through the line a little bit to pick up 4. But we're trying to bring on Baker a little slowly here. We don't want to rush him back too much, make him do anything too crazy, so we're trying to make it as simple as humanly possible. Now, look at Baker out here throwing dots, finds Isaiah. Isaiah's going to carry a couple of defenders in for the first. Got Baker in the center now, Isaiah in the backfield. This ball's thrown across the middle to Jarvis Landry, who picks up 8. Second and barely a yard here. Baker moves back under center. Isaiah here in the halfback toss. Tries to find some room, but the Rams weren't having any of that outside run. This is why we got Baker Mayfield. So let's see what he can do here on third and short. Isaiah's on a stand for pass protection. The ball's thrown quickly to Jarvis Landry, who again gets another catch today. You can tell the offense is moving so much better without EJ. And look, EJ, you came in and did your thing, and you played marginally well, but this team was built for Baker Mayfield and Isaiah. Browns are feeling pretty good right now. They're almost in the red zone. This ball's thrown across the middle, nearly picked off as it's batted around multiple times. Browns are looking to give Isaiah the ball here on second down. Isaiah's trying to get to the edge. He's got a guy in front of him. Jukes one guy. Oh, throws another one to the ground like a small child, and I think he's got the first. Even though we're playing at home, they actually gave us a pretty bad spot, in my opinion, so it's third down and inches. Who is going to be better here? Our offensive line or their defensive line? And the answer is our offensive line, or maybe it's just Isaiah. Pushing people through the pile down to the 5. Now, as much as we want to give Isaiah the ball here, look, we need to get Baker Mayfield's confidence back up. He's been out for a couple of weeks. The young fella's just trying to get, you know, back in the swing of things. Isaiah's back here, pass protection. Baker's going to roll around, and unfortunately, Baker forgot that people are trying to sack him if he rolls outside. That was definitely unfortunate, Baker. You know, he's still trying to warm up a little bit. Baker's rolling back out here to the left. Oh, God. Isaiah says, look, I'm going to try to block for you. Isaiah throws a block. Baker slides, but he could have had the touchdown. I'm going to be honest. Not getting a touchdown here is definitely a failure. I don't care if Baker is just coming back. We need this touchdown. We got to set us, you know, the tempo here against the Rams at home. Baker's got the ball and throws it to someone in the dog pound. We're disappointed not getting a touchdown here. So we settled for a field goal, and as you can tell, the Rams went ahead and put up 7 points on the board in a pretty quick fashion. So look, Isaiah says, next time we're in the red zone, coach, just give me the ball and let me get into the end zone. So with the ball in the 33, we've got a lot of work in front of us. We want to get back into the end zone. Little halfback toss here to Isaiah. He's got some room, spins, not his best move, and he's back to the line. So it's third down and one. I think the Rams pretty much know what's coming, but last time we ran it on short yardage, they couldn't stop us, and this time they couldn't do it either. Now Isaiah's lining up at wide receiver this time. Baker's got the ball in shotgun. Isaiah's running deep, and the ball goes elsewhere, and we get a couple of yards. That was a solid 9-yard completion there to David Njoku. Let's see if we can keep the chains going here on second and one. Good play action fake. Isaiah ready to block. This ball's thrown deep to Jarvis Landry, and Landry's going to pick up a chunk of yards. You can start to feel it now. Baker's getting a couple more passes under his belt. He's feeling a little bit better in the pocket, throwing some dots. And the pass to Landry was tough. That was in between multiple defenders. Ooh, Isaiah with a tough run. Only gets three. Getting pretty close to halftime as the second quarter is almost over. Or halfway over, excuse me. Isaiah through the middle. This ball is going to be thrown to a wide open. And Njoku, who's not going to catch that one because it's way too far away. So we've got a third down and seven. Again, we need Baker to come up big here on third down. Isaiah blocking. And again, Njoku wide open. Baker can't find it. So the good news is we do get a field goal. The bad news is the Rams still have a one-point lead. So we're going to line up Isaiah QB, see what he can get here. Duke Johnson's going to move out. Isaiah's out here running. Isaiah's got great blocking. He's got one guy in front of him. Jukes him out of his shoes. Isaiah's trying to keep running. He's got a couple guys chasing him. Isaiah's going to go into the end zone untouched. Ladies and gentlemen, the young fella says, oh, about time, baby. 30th career rushing touchdown there for Isaiah. Great moves, a nice juke, and the young fella put on the afterburner so Marcus Peters couldn't even catch him. Now the Rams actually go and turn it over, so it's about a minute and 30 left here in the first half. We've got an opportunity, again, to put some points on the board. And this ball's thrown behind to Isaiah. He is going to catch it, but he only gets five. Isaiah lining up the wide receiver again here on second and short. Baker Mayfield got plenty of time, throws it out to the right. This one is going to be caught, I believe, and it only gets four. So it's third down and one. We've basically converted four out of six times on third down. It's been basically pretty good for us. Now Isaiah says, look, I'm going to get a chunk of yards here down to the 44. First down again here, 45 seconds left. See Baker and shotgun with Isaiah to his left. Play action fake, great blitz pickup there from Isaiah. It's very rare that we actually say that, and David Njoku only gets about five. So it's a big second down. It's 35 seconds left. We have one timeout, and we need to get a big chunk of yards. Baker throws it in between two guys, neither which of one had a chance to catch it. At this point for Baker, we just basically want to make sure we get in field goal territory. Baker's going to sit here. Oh, Baker's going to break a tackle. Baker's rolling, and he gets rid of it. There's a lot of different things you can say about that play, but as we start the second half here with about 5:20 left, I'm not happy with Baker there. Look, you shed the block. Do something with the rock at that point. Like, I don't know what you're going to do with it. Just look down the field, run with it, do something other than throw it away on third down. The good news for Cleveland, though, is that even though Baker is showing signs of greatness and then also struggling at times, Isaiah's put on a heck of a game. He already has over 100 yards, and he just forgot to block there, apparently. Mark Barron is a big sack. So the Browns find themselves tied up 13-13 here in the third quarter with a big third down and 10. Can Baker convert? Does it underneath? Probably not the best option there, and he plays it safe, which leads to another punt for the Browns. So Johnny Hecker's going to line up here from about the 40, kicking one deep, and that dude's got a boot on him as he kicks it all the way down to basically the one. Isaiah looking for some room, didn't make a move, and he's down at the 7. So the Browns are going to pick it up here, first and 10, deep, and I mean deep in their own territory. So with Baker struggling a little bit, let's hand the ball off to Isaiah, let him go right up the middle, picks up 11 on that carry. We're still kind of waiting for Baker to take a deep shot. He took one, like, medium, intermediate shot, but nothing really deep down the field. So drawing up a play action here. This one's going deep. He lost one up a little bit. That one is caught by Josh Gordon, who nearly got decapitated. And David Njoku's actually going to get injured on this play. I mean, what a grab by Josh Gordon. I mean, getting hit that hard and holding on to it. That's kind of crazy. Isaiah again, streaking through the middle. He's going to get hit by LaMarcus Joyner on that play, but he still gets a chunk of yards. Got a second to five here again. Play action fake. Isaiah staying back to block. Mayfield's going to throw one. This one goes to Carter, and Carter hauls it in at the 37. I'm not even going to front. I've never seen that guy on the team before. So, congrats on your first career catch. No idea who you are. Hand the ball back off to Isaiah. Finding some room here again. Met by the linebackers and safeties, but he's dropped at the 30. Third quarter's almost down to a close here. Baker Mayfield looking to keep this drive going. Isaiah stays in a block. Isaiah's going to roll out. This ball is thrown deep to the right corner, and it's just a little bit too far for Josh Gordon to catch it. Third and three, 20 seconds left, needing something here. Isaiah finds some room. I think he has enough. They say he's at the 27. They say it's a conversion. Isaiah is now over 150 yards rushing today, which is just wild to think about. He's out in the open field. He's got one guy in front. He tries to truck through him, but he wasn't having any of them. That's the end of the third quarter. Here in shotgun again. Baker, this is your opportunity to shine. Can you get something going? Throws it out to the flats here. David Njoku. Njoku's going to move down to about the 8. We got second down and 6 from the 8-yard line. Again, don't need all the yards to get a first down, but that would be nice. Quick check down here to Josh Gordon. He's going to catch it at the four. We've got a big third down and three here. If we get a touchdown here, we take the lead. We'll be feeling pretty comfortable. But if we don't, it's a field goal, and our defense has a lot of pressure on him here in the rain. So the halfback tosses out to Isaiah, and they stop him at the four. No dice for the Browns. It's field goal time again. Now, the good news is that we end up getting the field goal, and then the Rams can't get anything going on offense. They got like 5 yards total of offense, and wait a second, that punt is horrible. So the Browns offense comes back out after a disappointing end to the last drive, only getting the field goal. But look, the Rams didn't do anything, and their punt was horrible because we have the ball basically at the 50 already, and Isaiah is still getting yards. Look at this dude, 173 yards on the ground. Second to four, Baker again under center. Isaiah staying back. This ball's across the middle to who else but David Njoku, and this time Baker doesn't overthrow him as he's down at the 30. I mean, I can't front. I want to see Baker Mayfield get a touchdown this game, whether it's rushing on his own or whether it's throwing a passing touchdown. We need him to be feeling good and getting a touchdown here, and just like that, he throws a dot to Jarvis Landry. Jarvis Landry's in the end zone. Baker Mayfield is back, people, and the Browns are up big now against the Rams at home. So the Rams had the ball, they drove down the field, and they went for it on fourth down, and as you can tell, they didn't get it. So look, 10-point lead, 4 minutes left. You know what we're going to do. Give the ball to the best player on the team. For the Rams, you got to be focused on one thing, stopping the running game. Because if you don't, you're not going to win this game. Now with 3 minutes left in the game, as you can tell, the Browns are running the ball nonstop. But wait a second, Isaiah's here in the Wildcat. He's taking the QB. Oh, he's going to actually hand it off this time. Isaiah for once handed it off, and it didn't actually work as Duke Johnson lost a bunch of yards. So with 2nd and 14, this play should basically take us to the 2-minute warning. So we're going to hand it off. Expect Isaiah to get out to the edge. He's actually going to get caught from behind a little bit, and they gang tackle him down to 33. Right now, the Rams run the risk. If they don't stop us here, they have literally no chance to come back in this ballgame. So Baker goes to a play action fake. Good little move. He throws one across the middle. It's time to set DeVolve, and DeVolve is going to hold it when it's the 16. We're in the red zone, and the Rams, they know it might be over. Baker definitely struggled at parts of this game, and I was a little disappointed in some of his third down plays, but the throws that he's making now late in the game, when you can tell that he's finally found his groove, they're just impressive. So 1:50 left now, 2nd and 9. Ball handed off to Isaiah, who's finding a gap. Isaiah's nearly into the end zone as he stopped at the 3, and the Rams use their last timeout. This is it. The Browns are trying to put this game away. You score here, it's basically game over. I mean, let's be honest. Right now, it's basically game over, but we're trying to get Isaiah into the record books, and Isaiah cuts up through the middle, stiff arms the guy to the ground, and he says, yup, that's another touchdown. Number 31 of his career. I think number 17 on the season, and the Browns are going to cruise to a big victory against the Los Angeles Rams. So the Rams tried, but in the end, it didn't really work out for them. We're going to walk out of here with a huge W, and Isaiah had another big game. And Baker Mayfield, you know what? He played all right in the end of it. Recap of the stats, Jared Goff went 25 of 38. Yeah, he threw 38 passes for 281 yards, 2 touchdowns, 1 interception. Baker Mayfield in his return looked pretty solid. Didn't test deep passes too much, maybe 1 or 2, but still high QB rating, solid yards, a good touchdown, and no turnovers for him. Isaiah absolutely shouldered the load today. 26 attempts, 208 yards, 2 touchdowns. Apparently he fumbled one time, which I don't recall, but still we'll take the big game by him. Into the receiving game, Robert Woods went 9 for 85, which is a huge game. Jarvis Landry 5 for 74, getting the only receiving touchdown for the Browns. And even Todd Gurley got into the game, but how about Cooper Kupp, 2 for 43? You thought he would have got in the game a little bit more, but they didn't throw it to him too much today. At the end of the day, big-time players make big-time plays. And while Isaiah stole the show with 200 yards on the ground, Baker Mayfield, the longer the game went on, definitely looked better. And look, that gives me something to be happy about, because the next few opponents we have, they are in for a beatdown.